What a lovely, lovely day for making a full English lesson. Oh, I feel so full of beans today. I can't wait to get started. Come on, quickly, quickly, quickly. Hello there. As you can see, I'm very busy at the moment. I'm putting some things I don't need into this skip. A skip is a large container used for putting big and heavy pieces of rubbish into. You use a skip to make the disposal of bulky refuse easier. Large skips are normally made of metal and they come in many sizes. This particular one is very large. It is very useful for the disposal of building debris. This container will be taken away soon and the contents will be safely disposed of. This container is called a skip in British English, while in American English it is referred to as a dumpster. Can you see what I'm holding here? It's one of my old hats. I rarely wear this hat anymore. There is a sentence in English that uses the phrase old hat as an idiom. If you describe something as being old hat, then you are saying that it is out of date or no longer used or done anymore. If something is repeated too often, then it can become old hat. Movies featuring vampires in them are seen as being old hat now. If a theme, story, or premise is shown too often, then we might become bored with it. We can say that this has been done to death. The superhero theme in movies has been done to death. There are too many talent shows on TV. They have been done to death. It is not surprising that some words in English can be confused with each other. A good example being compliment and compliment. One has an E in the middle, while the other has an I. Compliment with an E means two or more things that match or go together well. The things in question are good together. They go together well. They complement each other. Your curtains really complement the carpet. A number of things needed to form a group is a complement. Then there is compliment with an I. With this spelling, we are offering praise or making a flattering remark. You are offering your compliments. You want to show your appreciation of something, so you offer a compliment. The meal was delicious. I would like to offer my compliments to the chef. To send a formal greeting to someone via another person is a compliment. Something offered as a free gift or as a way of showing thanks for loyalty is complimentary. We are all human, and as humans, we all share certain things. There are things we all do. Some of these things are a little embarrassing, yet we still do them. For example, we all go to the toilet. We all have to go pee-pee and poo-poo.
These actions are seen as being taboo, in that they are rarely discussed openly. Yet we all do it. It is a perfectly natural thing to do. To wee or pee means that we are expelling the waste from our body in liquid form, like water. The proper medical term for wee-wee is urine. To expel solid waste is to poo or poop. The medical term is defecate. Sometimes it is hard to poo. However hard you try, it just won't come out. This is called constipation. You are constipated. Eating plenty of food containing fibre and drinking plenty of water can prevent you from becoming constipated. It is possible to have the opposite problem, where you cannot stop pooping. It keeps coming out all sloppy and watery, and it can feel just as uncomfortable as constipation. Watery poop is called diarrhea. You have a bout of diarrhea. You are suffering from diarrhea. This is normally caused by a stomach bug or an infection in your lower gut. So, constipation causes your poop to be too hard and difficult to push out, while diarrhea makes your poop turn to liquid and is hard to keep in. Peeing and pooping might be an awkward subject for many, but don't forget, we all do it. In English, we often express the occurrence of irony. We say that something is ironic. An ironic thing is something that expresses or shows the opposite meaning or mirrors an event by expressing the opposite outcome. A simple case of irony would be something designed to save lives being found to be causing death. Another example could be a person finding their true love while they are getting divorced. Irony can be subtle. We often point out an ironic situation as a way of expressing frustration or sadness. A sad irony could be a close relative dying on another relative's birthday. Finding something at the same time as losing something can be expressed as ironic. To do something opposite on purpose, so as to make a point or raise an issue, can be described as being ironic. A sense of irony can often leave a very deep impression on those who have felt it. Can you see what I'm holding here? It is a piece of marshmallow. This sweet food is very strange to touch. It is soft and spongy. It is quite squishy and can be squeezed and squashed easily. What I love about it is how it returns to its usual shape after being squashed. You can toast marshmallows by the fire or just eat them as they are. They come in many different flavours and are very sweet. Perfect for someone like me with a sweet tooth to enjoy. Are you a quirky person? Do you know someone who is quirky? The word quirky describes a person who has an odd character or whose behaviour contains many oddities. The word quirk describes the presence of an idiosyncrasy. A quirky person has many quirks. It would be fair to say that we all have at least one odd habit, although for most of the time it goes unnoticed. A quirky person might be seen as being a little eccentric or weird, but in a nice way. I'm often described as being a little quirky. I wonder why. If something bad happens that you are responsible for, do you try to make an excuse or do you give a reason? We often see making excuses as a way of avoiding responsibility for our actions. You make an excuse so as to vindicate yourself, to prove that it was not your fault. An excuse can be a form of defence. That is to say that you had no control of the situation in hand. We often react badly to excuses. It is as if the person giving the excuse is trying to avoid responsibility for their actions. For some, it is better just to hear the honest reason for something happening than to try and make up an excuse. What's really strange about this behaviour is that both reason and excuse are synonyms of each other. Yet it would appear to be better just to explain the reason than to try and wriggle out of it by making excuses. Perhaps it is better just to own up and admit your error than to try and justify it with an excuse. I don't know about you, but I think today's lesson went by very, very quickly. Sadly, that is all I have time for today. But don't worry, I will see you all again very soon for Full English number 8. Yes, it's true. This is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of the English language. That is, of course, England, saying to you, thanks for watching me teaching you. And of course, until next time, ta-ta for now. Oh no, I'm out of toilet paper.